Hello, my gorgeous goddesses, and today I'm gonna have a little chat with you about, it's gonna be a womanly talk, all things girly, and it's gonna be about our little flower down there and its health and what we can do to really support it and nourish it and nurture it, because I know for myself when I was younger, as well as a lot of my friends, we experience a lot of like problems down there, and we do the contraceptive pill. You know, there is just so much that happens and we hold so much of our power and energy and like healing and trauma in our root chakra and our yoni and our flower. So if you're a guy, probably you should click off because it's gonna get very personal. But as a guy, if you're interested to know more about the moon cup and how we use it and about the yoni egg and natural way of contraception. So if you'd like to see more of this, then keep on watching and I'm going to share with you all my little tips and tricks. Let's get started. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Marsha and I've been vegan for about 5 years now, and I feel that like since being vegan, a lot of my outlooks on things have changed. So part of that, obviously, I try to eat as organic as I can, and I eat a very sort of balanced but healthy plant-based diet. And I feel that when I was a teenager growing up in London, you know, being sexually active and things like that, but I was always so sensitive to like energies and things, so I used to always get all these like small problems down there, like thrush and urine infections, and I was in a long-term relationship as well, so I was on a contraceptive pill, and I've tried the patch and I've tried the injection and I've just tried all these different kind of contraceptions when I was young and in a relationship, and obviously I didn't want to get pregnant when I was like 17. I've stopped sort of taking the pill and all those other contraceptives before sort of going into my 20s, and since going vegan I found that I definitely don't want to have hormones and chemicals and all this like yucky stuff in my body. So I've kind of just been researching into other alternative ways and finding out what would be good for me and my yoni that's not gonna freak out. Like, I used to have these like pigmentation all over my chest, and that was from contraceptive pills that I was taking because of all this stuff that's in there. And I mean, like, you could definitely look into why the contraceptive pill is bad for you, not saying that, but there are so many different other ways to really know your body and to know yourself as to how you can prevent pregnancy if that's not what you want. So I'm gonna show you what I'm doing now for contraception, but first of all I wanted to talk to you about the yoni egg, which is basically like a egg-shaped crystal. And I ordered mine from the Yoni Pleasure Palace here in Australia, and it comes with this most sensual, and that's their founder, Rosie. She's the nicest girl you'll ever meet. Like, she's just so helpful. She sends me videos if I have any questions. You know, we're part of like an amazing group on Facebook where we share so many different like intimate stories and things like that. It's been about maybe like just maybe under 3 months since I've had it, and I got the red carnelian, which is a stone for the sacral chakra, which where I had a lot of blockages and a lot of things that I needed to really release. So basically I got this red carnelian egg, so it looks like this, and I got the hold one. You can get like with holes or without a hole, or with a hole, which is I'm gonna explain to you later. But basically the reason why I got this, because I heard so many people talk about the jade egg, which is incredible for you to just like awaken. It's very healing. So jade egg, everybody talks about the jade egg, but on the website you can actually choose different crystals that you could have, and I just resonated with the red carnelian because it is linked to the sacral chakra, which is what I felt like I needed to work on. So after my last relationship ended in like March, I felt a lot of just stagnant, very not good energy, like in my womb and my whole kind of like area down there. Like I really needed to just like cleanse that, releasing and healing and letting go of my last partners and just really clearing out my womb and just a whole of, you know, the area down there. So after I got the egg, basically I went and cleansed it in the ocean, or you can bury it in ground for the night, or you could just cleanse it in like salt water. So I cleansed it in the ocean, I charged it with the full moon light, and I charged it with the sun. And you know, you have to just basically hold it in your hands and just put really good intention into it, just ask it to do whatever you want it to do. Yes. I've been using this for about 3 months now, or just under 3 months, and let me tell you, it's just been, my personal experience has been the fact that I feel that I really have reconnected to myself a bit more, because you know, Rosie advises to, it's basically part of, such a massive part of self-love. So many people, women, are numb down there and they're incapable of experiencing orgasms. They never really like self-pleasure, and it's all healthy things to do. And I feel that, like for me, I definitely feel that it has reawakened me in many ways, because of the kind of the rituals that you have to do to lead up to, you know, having this sacred practice. And Rosie recommends to just like start in a shower, just like massage your breasts and just like, you know, just really get yourself not aroused, but just touch your body the way you want to be touched. And and then just to basically how I've been using it is just using coconut oil to just like massage myself and just like relax. And then you insert the egg this way up, so the big side goes inside of you. And again, just don't like shove it in. You have to basically let the yoni like take the egg. So again, it's not something to, you know, do quickly to just like get one off. It's about kind of like, I usually do it in my sort of self-loving evenings where I have a bath and I have candles and I do my saging and I do my journaling and all these other rituals that I have. And then I get the yoni egg that I tend to usually sleep next to, so you can get your energy and everything else. So, and then yeah, I just basically get in the groove of things and then slowly let the yoni take the egg. And then you just, I usually do like put it up as far as it can go, and I usually do it in the evenings and I sleep with it for the whole night so it can do its thing during the night. And then in the morning I wake up and like, I forget that it's even there, and then usually just pops out whenever it's ready to. I have tried, the holes are for to put like an two floss in there that's not centered or anything else, but actually I really like, for me, I don't even need a drilled one because I don't have any problems getting it out, because I tend to just like kind of birth it, as they call it. Usually sometimes when I'm like on in the morning when I'm going to the toilet, it will just like pop out. Or if I really, sometimes in the mornings it doesn't come out and I just get on with my day, and then again it comes to a point where it's ready to come out. But if you're if you are wearing it in the daytime, when I've wore it in daytimes, when I start to feel like a bit of an ache, like a kind of like a period type pain, just a very mild one, then I'll just basically go and kind of squeeze my pelvic floor muscles and it pops out really easily. So it can never go like way up you, and I sleep with it, and I really love sleeping with it. But for using the egg for nearly 3 months now, I found that I'm definitely much more connected to myself. I'm a lot more like just in touch with my feminine side. I feel like I've stepped into my real like goddess mode. And to basically highlight that, I've attracted this wonderful man into my life who is very spiritual, and he's very sensitive to like energies and everything else. And when we did have an intimate moment, it was so beautiful and profound, and it was just beautiful to just have everything that I've been feeling about myself to be re-emphasized by somebody who actually can see and realize these things. And it was just such a beautiful experience, and it was my first experience since my ex. And you know, I really did feel myself so much like tighter and firmer, and everything was so much more sensitive, but in a good way. So I actually came 3 times, and it was just incredible. But I feel that like you also have to be so comfortable with someone and really just surrender yourself. And I knew that, you know, during this whole experience, it was just, he was there for me, like he wasn't there for him. And it was just such a different experience to after using the yoni egg, you know, for me, the sex that I had before with my ex, to the sex that I had now after using the yoni egg. And maybe obviously it does, the partner obviously does make a difference as well. And it was just super yummy, and I really loved it. And I feel that it was just so it was like soul food for me, because I have long gaps of like not being intimate and not having sex and keeping myself to myself, which in some ways I feel that like I block my creativity and that sacral chakra and my root chakra to experience things. But at the same time, I'm very picky of who I let in as well. So, you know, to have this experience, it was just so gorgeous, and I felt like an absolute goddess. And so you should feel like an absolute goddess when you have intimate moments like that, totally. And that's what I got to learn through having, you know, just being on a journey of self-love and discovering my self-worth and really knowing what I'm worth, and knowing that not every man deserves me, and not every man that wine and dines me deserves to sleep with me. And it's somebody who really truly sees me for who I truly am, and not just like my beauty and my luscious hair, but actually somebody who is just as gorgeous, you know, somebody who is amazing. And I feel that I'm very selective of who I let in into that sacral, really intimate and very precious like side of me. So that's been my yoni experience. I really highly recommend like every woman. I mean, in the leaflet that Rosie gives you with the egg, it says like you experience deeper, longer, stronger orgasms. You awaken the vaginal tissue, prevent inconvenience, weak bladder. So I definitely felt that sometimes when I used to sneeze, I used to like wee a little bit. So I did need to like strengthen my pelvic floor. And after this, I definitely have stopped. But after I did have that intimate moment, the next couple of days, like I would sneeze and I would wee again. So I know it was kind of got weakened by the experience. But it's fine again. The yoni egg, it also kind of, the benefits of it is to become more connected to your feminine sexuality, increasing your libido, boost natural lubrication. And let me tell you, that definitely happened. So that's basically the yoni egg. You can get them online. Check out Yoni Pleasure Palace on Instagram as well. She does really amazing yoni certified, you know, eggs, and these crystal pleasure wands as well. I really want to get the rose quartz one, which is supposed to be like next level. Yeah, so I really love that. And then leading on from the intimacy, my next little thing is Moon Cups by Gypsy Vibes. So I met this girl actually on one of the farmers markets here. And again, leading on from just being ethical and being vegan and wanting to reduce my sort of waste and stuff, I just realized that how wasteful it is to use pads, sanitary pads. And then I've stopped using tampons really a long time ago because again, I didn't resonate with it anymore. You know, again, there is so much stuff out there about tampons, and if you are using them, make sure to use organic ones that are from organic cotton and they're like toxic free. So then I just thought, well, you know, actually I need to explore more, and like I don't want to be using pads anymore. So lots of my girlfriends have been using the Moon Cup. So this is what it looks like. It's a very soft silicone, and you basically insert this in you when you're on your period, and it gets the blood all in there. So me and my girl Sammy, we actually got two for the price of one. And the Moon Cup is an eco-conscious, gentle and divine sacred feminine hygiene product. So made with flexible medical grade silicone, is warm inside the vagina to catch your menstrual flow. The cup can be emptied every 4 to 12 hours. So obviously, yeah, you could just leave this in 4 to 12 hours and be fine with it. Initially, I really struggled to get in because a lot of people say to like insert it like that, but that just wouldn't go inside me. There was no way. So then I actually found a way to insert it like so. So when you basically insert it like that, it's much easier and just feels much like better. And then basically the cup opens up as soon as it's in. And once it's in, it does feel, initially if it was uncomfortable, you do have to get used to it. But this Moon Cup is super soft. Like it's a lot softer than what my girlfriends have, the ones that have different brands. So I would definitely recommend this one. And yeah, it feels like a tampon when it's in, and then you leave it, and then you just basically pull this little thing out, and then all the blood, like you will see, it would be like be covered in blood as well, but it's all the blood is in there as well, and you just kind of pull it out, and then you wash it, and then you put it up again. So if you're traveling, if you're just basically somewhere where you just can't keep constantly like changing tampons or changing pads, you know, this is a really good way. And again, it's so much more eco-friendly because you're not just overcrowding the landfills with pads with your blood all over them. The only downside, it is a bit messy, I find. Like for me, when, you know, I need to have like a sink in the same sort of cubicle as the toilet, because it's not like you're gonna go to the public toilet, like take the cup out and then like go outside where everywhere else is washing their hands and just be like washing out your blood in the sink. Like that's not what you would do. So, and even like when I'm at home and I'm washing it, it just feels like there is just blood all over the sink and stuff, and it just kind of feels like, oh, like, you know, this is where I wash my face. And but at the same time, we're all connected and it's my fluids, so I'm fine with that in some ways. But yeah, no, it's definitely a little bit messier than just taking that tampon out and just flushing it down the toilet, so bear that in mind. But I generally feel that this is the way forward if you do want to reduce your waste. Gypsy Vibes, she does lots of other really cool products, so check her out. She's Gold Coast based and also has got a website, so you could always order her cup or go and see her at the Green Marquee, which is where I met her. And my last but not least little tip on, you know, just the when it comes to women's stuff and contraception, is I have been using Natural Cycles, which you've probably seen advertised everywhere on like social media and stuff. But I do find that actually this is an amazing way for me to know my body even deeper, knowing when I'm, you know, ovulating, knowing when I'm fertile, knowing when what my cycle is like. It's really just by putting the information into the little app. So the green days is when I can have sex without any contraception, and then on the red days, this is when I should use protection. So it's very accurate, and the more you use it, the better, the more accurate it gets as well. So you get a little thermometer that you, it's a special one, and you basically measure your temperature every morning as soon as you wake up, and then you put the, you put your basically your temperature and anything else that you're experiencing into this, and then it comes back saying no protection or use protection, which I really like. And it's, again, it's just, I'm not putting any chemicals in my body, and I'm not putting any hormones in my body, and it's me getting to know my body even further. So for all you goddesses out there that are looking for alternative ways other than pill, I still believe that you should obviously use condoms where need be. I really been loving this journey deeper into myself and my sensuality and my feminine and like, just like my goddessness. So thank you so much for watching, and if you're a guy, now you know a lot of information. So be sure to check me out on World Within Her and subscribe to this channel. This is like a very different video to what I've normally do, but I really feel that this would be useful for a lot of the girls that follow me, and it's something that I am passionate about, and it's something that I'm definitely want to put out there. So, and yeah, be sure to check out Moon Cup and Natural Cycles and Pleasure Palace and Rosie if you're keen. So yeah, thank you so much guys, and I hope you have a lovely day, and I will see you soon. Bye guys.